What's up, everybody? Welcome to a new English bit. I'm Katia, and in today's lesson, we're going to focus on advanced irregular verbs by doing a quiz that I've prepared for you. They are less common and trickier verbs than those we use on a daily basis. Are you ready for the grammar challenge? If so, grab a pen and a piece of paper. And let's dive in. So in the first part of the video, I'm going to give you 11 sentences with a gap in each and an infinitive. And your task is to put the verb into the correct grammar form and write down your answers. It's really important not to skip this part. And in the second part of the lesson, I'm going to give you the correct answers so that you can find out how good you are at advanced irregular verbs. So let's get started. The first sentence is ouch, you, gap, on my foot. Ouch, you, gap, on my foot. So the verb you have to use is to tread, and you need to put it into the correct grammar form. A hint, you have to use past simple in this sentence. So write down your answer. It's really important. Write it down. And in the second part of the lesson, we're going to find out if this answer is correct. Let's move on to our second question. Oh no, my sweater has gap in the wash. Oh no, my sweater has gap in the wash. So the verb you have to use is to shrink, and I'm going to help you. You need to use present perfect. So it's the third column, past participle. Write down your answer. And this is my favorite sweater. It's so soft. Let's continue number three. He gap from his home country in search of a better life. He gap from his home country in search of a better life. The verb you need to put into the correct form is to flee. To flee. So the same, write down your answer. Number four, the car gap on the ice. The car gap on the ice. The verb you have to use in this case is to spin. So think carefully and write down your answer. Number five, he gap to me in panic. He gap to me in panic. The verb you have to put into the correct grammar form is to cling. To cling. Don't forget to write down your answer. Let's move on to number six. Jess gap her engagement ring at her boyfriend when she found out that he had been cheating on her. Jess gap her engagement ring at her boyfriend when she found out that he had been cheating on her. The verb you have to use is to fling. To fling. And of course, write down your answer. Number seven, he gap her when she was in need. He gap her when she was in need. The verb you have to put into the correct form is to forsake. Forsake. Number eight, I've just gap some coffee. I've just some coffee. So the verb you have to use is to grind, to grind. And if you have seen my previous video, then you must know the answer. Number nine, she gap her keys on the table. She gap her keys on the table. And the verb is to sling, to sling. Number 10, they gap last year. They gap last year. The verb is to wet. To wet. And the last sentence is I gap in the countryside last weekend. I gap in the countryside last weekend. The verb you have to use is to unwind. To unwind. So write down your last answer and now we're going to check if they are correct. And before we continue, just a super quick reminder to subscribe to my channel and activate the bell. And now let's move on to the second part of the lesson where I'm going to give you the correct answers to the questions. The first sentence is, ouch, you trod on my foot. Ouch, you trod on my foot. The verb is to tread, trod, trodden. To tread, trod, trodden. It's level C2 and it means to put your foot on something. We can also say to step on something instead. It's a synonym. So remember, to tread, trod, trodden. Let's move on to our second sentence. My sweater has shrunk in the wash. My sweater has shrunk in the wash. So the verb is to shrink, shrank, shrunk. To shrink, shrank, shrunk. It's level B2 and it means to become smaller in size, especially as a result of being washed. To shrink, shrink, shrink. Was it correct? Let's continue our sentence number 3. Is he fled from his home country in search of a better life? He fled from his home country in search of a better life. So the verb is to flee, long E, fled, fled. To flee, fled, fled. It's level C1 and it means to escape by running away, especially because of danger or fear. So to flee, fled, fled. Number 4, the car spun on the ice. The car spun on the ice. The verb is to spin, spun, spun. To spin, spun, spun. It's level C1 and it means to turn around and around, especially fast. Was it correct? Number 5, he clung to me in panic. He clung to me in panic. So the verb is to cling, clung, clung. To cling, clung, clung. It's level C2 and it means to hold somebody or something tightly. Let's move on to number 6. Jess flung her engagement ring at her boyfriend when she found out that he had been cheating on her. Jess flung her engagement ring at her boyfriend when she found out that he had been cheating on her. The verb is to fling, flung, flung. To fling, flung, flung. And it means to throw something or somebody with force, especially because you're angry. To fling, flung, flung. Number 7, he forsook her when she was in need. He forsook her when she was in need. The verb is to forsake, forsook, forsaken. Forsake, forsook, forsaken. And it means to leave somebody or something, especially when they need you. It's a synonym of to abandon. To forsake, forsook, forsaken. Was it correct? Number 8, I've just ground some coffee. I've just ground some coffee. The verb is to grind, ground, ground. To grind, ground, ground. And it means to crush something into small pieces or powder. To grind, ground, ground. Number 9, she slung her keys on the table. She slung her keys on the table. The verb is to sling, slung, slung. To sling, slung, slung. And it means to throw something in a careless way. To sling, slung, slung. Number 10, they wed or wedded last year. Both options are correct. They wed or wedded last year. So the verb to wed can be regular and irregular. If it's irregular, it would be to wed, wed, wed. And if it's regular, they wedded. We add ed. So both options are correct. And the meaning of to wed is to marry somebody. And the last sentence is I unwound in the countryside last weekend. I unwound in the countryside last weekend. The verb is to unwind, unwound, unwound. Unwind, unwound, unwound. So be careful with the pronunciation in the infinitive. It's not to unwind, but unwind. To unwind. And it means to relax and stop worrying and thinking about problems. So guys, how did it go? Anybody who got 11 out of 11? If so, congrats. Anyway, let me know your score in the comments below. So guys, I hope you enjoyed this English bit. If you did, don't forget to give it a huge thumbs up, to share it with your friends and family while learning English, and subscribe to my channel. There is a weekly video. And of course, don't forget to do my daily quiz on Instagram. Have a lovely Sunday. With that being said, thanks for watching and see you next week. Ciao for now.